you have a CZ75 series pistol and you're looking to upgrade some things, these are the top 5 things you can do to upgrade your pistol. What's up, everyone? Thanks for stopping by. I am the Average Doomsday Prepping Dude. So as you can see on my SP01, I've upgraded and modded the crap out of this thing. I've pretty much upgraded or modified every single component you can on my SP01. So I can honestly tell you what I think are the top 5 things you can do to your CZ pistol to upgrade. And keep in mind, this top 5 upgrades is not for the Shadow series or the Tactical Sports because their mechanics are a little bit different than the regular CZ75. So I'm going to be doing my top 5 a little bit different than other people normally do it. I'm not going to be doing mine backwards as I count them from 5 to 1. I'm actually going to be doing it from 1 to 5. So the most important thing is going to be first. So if you're budgeting your build on your CZ pistol, you can actually do it in order as I show you. Before we begin, please take the time to hit that little red button below to like and subscribe, as I have plenty of do-it-yourself content for many CZ platform pistols, the SP01, the Shadow 2, as well as the Tac Sports, and I have plenty of other do-it-yourself content for Berettas, as well as USPSA shooting competition videos if you're trying to get into USPSA shooting. Alright, so the first and most important thing you need to be doing to upgrade and improve your CZ75 pistol is to replace the firing pin retaining pin. I already have an entire video explaining on why you need to do this as well as how to do this, but let me give you a brief summary of why you need to do this. So the firing pin retaining pin is a roll pin, a very, very cheap roll pin. It's actually what I find to be the weak link of all CZ pistols. So CZ Custom makes a solid steel retaining pin for around $8, and that's what I use in my pistols. So you're probably wondering why a roll pin is the first thing on my list to replace and upgrade, as opposed to, you know, trigger sights or something else on the pistol. And quite frankly, it's because no one knows to replace this part unless you've actually found a video kind of explaining why you need to replace it. Now, in my prior do-it-yourself video explaining why and how you need to do this, a lot of people were actually making comments that they reached out to CZ to find out what their official stance on this is, because, you know, a lot of people didn't know about this until they found my video. CZ's official stance is that you should actually be replacing it with the factory roll pins and not a solid steel pin, because it may void the warranty, so do this at your own discretion. But my stance on it is that why would you put cheap roll pins into a pistol when they know it's prone to failure? They were saying that, you know, you should just buy a whole bunch of roll pins and keep them on hand for replacement because they're only like a buck or two. But again, that seems stupid. When you buy other CZ pistols, they have spare parts such as the buffers in your Shadow 2, or they have extra slide stop pins because they know those parts are going to break. They know they're replaceable parts, so they give you a couple extras. They don't give you any extra replaceable roll pins. And they don't have any warning signs saying, hey, by the way, if you live fire and dry fire this, your roll pin is going to go bad. Please replace it. So that being said, I think it's a design flaw more than anything else. So I put in solid steel roll pins into mine, and that's what I recommend for you. But CZ's official stance is that you should be putting in the factory roll pins because they actually are supposed to give way and be destroyed over time. When you do replace your factory roll pin, please leave a comment below. Let me know how many rounds approximately you put through the pistol along with your dry fire, as well as how deformed the factory roll pin is. This way we can kind of track to see what the longevity of these factory roll pins are for the entire community to see. So the other roll pin I recommend you replace is the roll pin that retains the trigger. Cage Gunworks makes a floating trigger pin for around $13. It's a solid steel piece that kind of just slips in, and it eliminates any kind of hammering you need to do to get out roll pins. $13 for a pin is quite expensive, honestly. The only reason why I buy them is because dealing with those stupid CZ factory roll pins is just a pain in the butt. They're complete garbage. They have to get rid of them. So when you take out that factory roll pin and you drop in this floating trigger pin, it makes working on your CZ that much easier because you're not having to hammer anything out, slip, maybe scratch your frame. It's just a lifesaver. So get rid of those junky CZ roll pins and just get the floating roll pin. All right, so the second thing you can do to improve and upgrade your CZ pistol is to replace the springs. two springs you need to replace, the trigger return spring and the hammer spring. Cajun Gun Works makes a reduced power trigger return spring for around $7, and they also make different various weight hammer springs. I put in a 13-pound blue spring into mine, but I think they have ones that go all the way down to 10, up to 15 or 16 pounds. I like it right in the middle at 13. Both those springs combined together will actually greatly reduce the amount of force you need to pull the trigger and give it a much smoother trigger pull. So for less than $20, that's one of the best upgrades you can do for your pistol, which is why it is number two. Since we're talking about replacing springs, there are going to be a couple honorable mentions before we get to my third recommendation for your upgrades. And the first honorable mention is going to be replacing your firing pin with an extended firing pin and reduced power firing pin spring. This can actually be easily replaced once you replace your firing pin retaining pin. And while you're doing that, you should also replace your firing pin block plunger spring, which runs around $5. They all can be replaced at the same time and should be used in conjunction with all the reduced power springs to increase your reliability. All right, so the third thing you can do to upgrade your CZ75 pistol is to upgrade the trigger. The factory trigger has this little C hook that actually rubs the bottom part of your finger and can be a little bit sharp and abrasive sometimes. So a lot of people like myself find it to be a little bit uncomfortable and want to replace it. Cajun Gun Works does have a whole bunch of different trigger options available. They have the 85C combat trigger as well as some short reach trigger kits that also come with some interrupters that allow you to improve the single action reset after your double action shot. The kits range from $35 just for the trigger all the way up to $90 for the complete kit. So it just depends on what budget and what kind of trigger profile you want. But any of them are a drastic improvement over the stock trigger. All right, coming in at number four, you should be upgrading your sights. Stock sights are just okay. I think they actually do glow in the dark, which is kind of nice for stock sights. But other than that, they don't really, you know, do anything special. So if you want to put some fiber optic front sights on like I have, or put in a nice blacked out rear sight, they make all kinds of different ones, both from CZ Custom, Cajun Gun Works, and CZ themselves. So, you know, everyone sees their sights differently and aims a little differently. So people want to visually see something different. So I personally think sights should be one of the top five things, and that's why it's number four. All right, and the fifth thing you can do to upgrade your pistol is upgrading the grips. CZs are known for their fantastic ergonomics, and the stock grips that come on them, the rubber ones, are, you know, they're okay. They are palm swells. They do actually fit very comfortably in my hands, at least. But they just don't add a lot of grippy surface. I like G10 grips. So to upgrade your grips to G10 grips, on the lower end would be the Cool Hand ones, and I think those start around $40 to $50, and then from there is VZ and Lock Grips. Lock Grips actually has very customized grips that you can get. Mine are Cobra inlaid grips. They run, you know, around $100 plus. You don't have to go too crazy like that if you don't want, but I like the checkered palm swell grips. They just fit my hand really, really well. But, you know, in the middle end spectrum is around, you know, $60 to $70 from VZ and Lock Grips. And they have all different kinds of colors and sizes, thin, palm swell, whatnot. But, you know, it's like the leather seats in your car or cloth seats, you know, however you like the lumbar support. They're a little bit different for everyone. You know, not everyone feels things the same. But definitely having improved grips will, you know, improve your feel on the gun, therefore giving you a more comfortable shooting gun and actually making you shoot a little bit better. So there you have it. Those are my top five recommendations for upgrades you can do to your CZ75 series pistol. If you haven't already, please take the time to hit that red button below to like and subscribe, as I'll be having more of these do-it-yourself and top five videos in the future. And if you have any questions or comments about anything you've seen, please feel free to leave a question or comment in the comment section below, and I'll be happy to answer you. With the coronavirus pandemic still going on around the world, please stay home and stay safe, and I will see you next time.